I'm Samantha Burford for Wbontv.com. After decades of planning and preparation, the destruction of the chemical weapons at the Bluegrass Army Depot are set to begin.
Visit the walk-in clinic at Irvin Primary Care on Friday evenings and weekends with no appointment necessary. A service of Mercy Health, Markham and Wallace Hospital. For those times when it's not serious enough to go to the ER, but you feel too sick to wait until Monday, visit Irvin Primary Care.
Well, today it was my privilege to give an update on the chemical weapons disposal project that's about to begin operations very shortly, and also to go over some of the ideas that we've been working on regarding the future and once this project is over. There are going to be over 1,500 workers that will be looking for work. There'll be a lot of infrastructure left, and the opportunities that this ready-made workforce provides for our existing industrial base and also to attract other companies to Madison County, I think is a great opportunity, and so I briefed folks on where we're at in that regard as well. At the current schedule has the personnel peaking at in 2022 at about 1,760 people. As operations continue and they are completed at the end of 2023, that number starts to decline significantly. Once the operation's over, there's 2 years of closure, which is when they decontaminate and take care of any of the issues associated with the project. But after 2 years after that, there's down to about 36 people. So they go from 1,760 to 36 over a period of about 3 years. That's a significant decline in the tax base, in all of the infrastructure in the county. I mean, people, you know, they buy groceries, they go to school, they rent apartments. All of these things are impacted when you have 1,700 people leaving. And so what we want to do is identify who those folks are, what their skills are, and see where we might be able to keep them in our existing industrial base, or perhaps attract other corporations that would like to take advantage of that skill set and that ready-made workforce and come here to Madison County.
Is there any other things that us in our community, other than following what's happening, is there anything we need to know or be prepared, or how can we help?
Well, I think the most important thing is to just be aware of what's going on and when. To understand that the risks associated with this are extremely small. And so I've had many people come up to me and say, oh, we're really getting nervous because they're going to start operations. Let me just reassure you, the safety protocols and the prevention mentality out there is extraordinary. But you always have to be prepared. And so you should pay attention to the CSEP program, the Chemical Stockpile Emergency Preparedness Program. You should know what zone you're in. You should know what actions to take should there be an event, which is very unlikely. And just understand what's happening, what phase we're in, and what to do if something should go wrong. And then just, you know, encourage and support the effort out there and let folks know that, you know, we're really getting close to getting rid of this stuff finally.
For more great stories like these, check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. I'm Samantha Burford for WBONTV.com.